Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In today's video we are going to learn about the fabrication of U Loop Canine Retractor. As you can see over here, it consists of an active arm that engages the canine. Now this active arm is followed by a U loop that follows the mesodistal width of the premolar and is covering the cervical 2 to 3 mm below the cervical line of this premolar, which is followed by a retentive arm and the retentive tag. Now this U loop canine retractor is used for the distal migration or the distal movement of the canine, which is a minimal distal movement that can be attained with this canine retractor. Now let's see the things that we require for its fabrication. The thing that we require are marker pen, we require a marking pencil, then we require a universal plier, then we require a hard wire cutter. Now we use for its fabrication 0.6 mm or 23 gauge round stainless steel wire. Now we are going to learn its fabrication on an ideal adult dentition cast on 2-3, that is the canine. So let's begin with the markings first. Now we will begin with the marking of the active arm. It will follow the middle third of the canine. As you can see over here, this is the active arm following the contour of the canine at the middle third, which will be followed by a U loop which will fall just 2 to 3 mm below the premolar, and later on it will go into the distal embrasure and will be followed by a retentive arm and finally the retentive tag. So now in the first step we need to straighten up this 23 gauge wire. So we will hold this wire, one end of this wire, in the flat base of this universal plier, and with the help of our finger and thumb pressure we will straighten it up. With the help of our finger and thumb pressure and based on our observation, we straighten it up. This straightening helps us remove the stresses or the residual stresses that are there in the wire. Now once we are done with the straightening, we need to cut the ends of this wire to get a perfectly straight wire. So we will cut both the ends of this wire. Now in the second step we will mark a center point. This will be the point where our U loop would be formed. We will begin with the formation of the U loop. Now engage this point in the middle rounded circular portion of the universal plier and roll out both the ends simultaneously to form a uniform loop shaped bend or uniform U loop. Now this completes our U loop. It must be symmetrical, and now we shall check it on the cast. It's adaptation. It should follow the marking. Now we will mark two points, one for the retentive arm that will go into the distal embrasure and one for the active arm that will cover the canine. Now first we will engage one point for the retentive arm in the rounded beak of the universal plier and give a sharp 90 degree bend as this. Now check its adaptation on the cast, that whether it is going correctly. Yes, it is going correctly. Now we need to mark other point so that we give a palatal adaptation, or begin with the palatal adaptation. So now again we will hold this point in the rounded beak of the universal plier and again give a sharp 90 degree bend. Remember to do not distort the plane at any moment of the time. Now we complete this bend and again check it. So as you can see that it is following the markings, and now we need to form the retentive tag so that we can cover up the parietal aspect of the U Loop Canine Retractor. So this completes the parietal aspect of the U Loop Canine Retractor, and minor adjustments can be done later on. Now we will begin with the active arm. So for that we will give a sharp 90 degree bend. Now this would be a horizontal bend, as you can see over here, away from the U Loop. Now when we have done with the horizontal bend for the active arm, we need to give a slight away bend from the canine. This will help in the counter adaptation of the active arm from the distal aspect to the medial aspect of the canine. So see this bend, that we are giving a slight outward bend from the canine. So now once we are done with this outward bend, we can remove the excess extra amount of wire by cutting it. Now once we have removed the extra amount of wire, we need to give a sharp bend and follow the counter of this canine. So we will engage this in the rounded portions of the universal plier and give a rounded adaptation for this canine, and now we will check it again so that it follows the contour of the canine. Now you can see that we have almost completed it. Now we can begin with our slight adjustments, one at the parietal aspect and again one at the active arm. So first we will engage the end of the active arm and give a sharp end, and now again holding the retentive arm and giving a sharp bend and following the palatal aspects. Now we can check it again. So now you can see that our both the arms, the active arm and the retentive arm, are following the adaptation. So now if any adjustments are required, then it can be done at this stage before embedding it into the acrylic. Now remember that the U Loop Canine Retractor should be engaging passively and not actively like a spring. So this completes our U Loop Canine Retractor. Now to check it in a closer view, we need to stabilize it. So we will stabilize it and then we will check it. So once we stabilize it, we can have a closer look from all the aspects and check its adaptation from all the aspects. So in a closer look, this is how it should be adapted. The active arm should follow the contour of the canine, followed by a U loop that is going 2 to 3 mm below the cervical line of the first premolar, and later on the retentive arm into up again from the distal aspect of the embrasure, followed by a retentive tag. So friends, thanks for watching this video. Please do like and subscribe to my channel. Bye bye, take care.